Greetings all who are on this world. We are the Quest Bros, and welcome back to more E3 week, this time with Square Enix.
Yes, we're here with Square Enix. Starting up in just about 40 seconds.
Now, Mr. Enix, what do you think will happen if, like the way you said it, it sounded like Square Enix was an actual person in the room.
Mr. Square Enix himself.
Mr. Enix, could you please tell us? No, please. Mr. Enix was my father. Call me Square. And do your goddamn job.
Yeah.
So when you come in with a smaller roster like Square is, it really is. Do you like Marvel? Do you like that? Well, if you don't like these things,
are they just chatting, or are we missing something?
Sure. Thanks, guys.
Where is Mercer, you fools? Show me the Mercer.
Okay, all right, ladies and gentlemen, it's time now. Break. Without further ado, here's Square Enix Presents.
Okay.
The rating for that went really quick, so hopefully you're okay with those ratings.
Yeah. Here,
and I'm back as your host of Square Enix Presents. Today we have a special
Matt Mercer.
It is.
With new game announcements, updates, and exciting news from our studio.
And me, as everyone.
So let's kick off with the world premiere of a brand new game from Eidos Montreal. We hope you enjoy the show.
I will now, just because of Matt Mercer.
Yeah, thank you, Matt. I will.
I always forget like what Square Enix actually like does or
what
IPs they have and the type of games they make, because I'm also used to just like JRPGs with Square Enix. Star-Lord?
Yep.
I'm getting just like a Guardians of the Galaxy thing, or is Star-Lord in this Marvel game now?
What? No, Rocket. So I let Groot fill out the paperwork.
Maybe.
That'd be cool, just a Guardians of the Galaxy game.
So we got fine. We appear to be
60. Yeah. It also looks like the actual comic book.
Yeah.
Need a plan.
If you see anything with claws the size of tracks, let me know.
We got this.
And the thing is, like, it's probably gonna have like that comedy and fun aspect of it.
Yeah. Also, they're using the same song from the fucking
Shrek.
No, well, yes, but also from the new He-Man trailer.
Oh, okay.
Although it could be used as a distraction.
I mean, I'm surprised. I wonder if they're also doing the two, because like the Avengers one didn't do great. Because I think it was just like the marketing for it wasn't as good as it could be. So not many people really understood anything about it. So I wonder if they're like, okay, let's try again.
This time.
Let's do it right this time. But we'll use the Guardians of the Galaxy. Because everyone who loves Marvel, loves the Guardians. Like, no one, who doesn't like the Guardians of the Galaxy?
I don't.
What?
I'm just kidding.
And you're wrong. Mantis.
Yeah,
and I feel like with a Guardians game you can have a lot more fun with it.
Space llama.
Yeah,
okay, it is a Guardians of the Galaxy game.
No, of course I will. I'll call you.
Yep, classic Star-Lord.
I even like how the tentacle went like.
Hi, my name's Olivier.
And in October, too.
Producer here at Eidos Montreal. All
right.
For the past few years, we've had the privilege to work on our version of Marvel's Guardians of the Galaxy and reimagine it into a single-player, story-driven, third-person action-adventure game. It's our own fresh take on the Guardians, and something that's really unique to our game is that you get to be Peter.
I mean, they're already coming out
as
strong.
As Star-Lord, you're constantly in the middle of the action as you try to lead this band of misfits. But today, I'm really, really excited to have all of you join us on this journey, and you'll hear more about the game from our team behind this project.
Right, let's do this. I've always loved Marvel's cosmic characters. Growing up as a kid, I read them, enjoyed them, loved them. I had the opportunity to write for Marvel on some of their cosmic titles. I went back with the help of Bill Roseman, the editor, and kind of cherry-picked characters from Marvel's past.
The opportunity here was to build a team, but to make it all underdogs, so that the reader would think, oh my gosh, how is this team gonna survive?
and that became the Guardians of the Galaxy comic, which we loved working on.
I remember,
and it's good too. Original story, don't really have too much to really have to, you have to follow.
Yeah.
Of course, there's just like the characters act this way, and you just stay with that. But it's not like you have to. You're setting a path. No baby Groot, just good classic Groot.
Yeah, good old adult Groot. I don't know why, but this version of Drax looks weird to me.
It's because he's skinny. What makes the
gameplay experience unique to me is no matter, I miss Batista in Drax, in all honesty. Exploration or you're fighting, the Guardians are constantly around you and you never feel alone. While you're the leader,
the Guardians will also challenge you and make decisions on their own. I also wonder like what other crossovers they might have, or like other characters they might introduce. Like if they would put in the Eternals, like you run into them at some point, or if Captain Marvel maybe makes an appearance. That's the thing, was like with the Galactic Marvel universe, there's so much. Your blasters and you're using
your jet boots. Star-Lord is really empowering. He's very agile on the battlefield. He can slide and over with his jet.
Wow, they're even showing like combat.
Of course, he has his elemental blasters that have different powers as well. And on top of all of this, he can use the unique abilities of his guardians.
We're not pirates. We're legally incorporated heroes for hire.
Gardeners of the Galaxy?
What? No!
The story is about a group of misfits, the Guardians. In our world, they've been together.
I wonder if there's any like famous voice actors in this.
They create
maybe
something on a small scale that looks.
Also, if they're gonna do the origin of how they get together, or they're just gonna be like, yeah, we're already we're a group of bandits. Like you just kind of throw you in.
There are a lot of very interesting
hope they
in the Marvel.
If they don't do it where it's like their origin, I hope they at least like reference back to it and say, hey, this is how we met.
Yeah.
Best for this story. That gives us the opportunity to bring in some that are well known, but some that are.
The Guardians of the Galaxy are like your stereotypical D&D campaign. And
it really are.
Yeah. Where they are literally just a bunch of idiots and assholes.
It's like to be a misfit family. They're also bringing an amazing imagination to it. You're going to see planets and characters that are going to blow your mind.
Interpreting it in its own way, I think, makes it feel incredibly fresh and exciting. It's not a matter of trying to replicate the comic or trying to replicate the film. It's trying to take the medium you're working in and make the best version of Guardians out of that.
You get to play as the other characters? Because it seemed like you've only been able to play as Star-Lord.
I think they said it was just Star-Lord.
Okay. I mean, that's fine, but I would like to play as the others.
When's the release date?
October.
Oh, it said October?
Yeah.
Wow. Okay. I'm with it.
Kurt's just drinking out of the watering can.
Yeah.
Units?
We appear to be 6,963 units short. We intend to keep our ship, Peter Quill.
I know. We clearly need a plan.
What about selling Gamora's crap?
Remember the one symbol on his jacket.
Since you first joined us, I mean, don't tell me they ain't worth nothing.
The quarantine zone was always
holding out on
my figurines are not knickknacks.
Team's in trouble, and you can't be bothered to make no sacrifice.
When I see Mantis, I only think of Chang Tao from Doctor Who, the Tenet era.
Yeah.
I think we should.
The Space Invader?
Well, no, because there's another one next to it, the white and black one.
You know, the only problem with your plan is that Lady Hellbender only buys monsters, and you are not a monster.
Groot, are you really offering to?
No, he is not offering that. Okay.
Could work.
Sell Groot? I guess we could bust him out after.
Absurd. Lady Hellbender seeks the monster within. The small, ugly one is clearly the correct choice. He's cruel, sadistic, and his soul is filthy and filled with rage.
I vote we sell Groot. I honestly think Lady Hellbender will go for it.
Yeah, well, I vote for not.
I also vote for the creepy little beast.
2 votes each. Peter?
I like how even Groot has a little bit of armor.
Yeah.
Vote to sell Groot, vote to sell Rocket. Well,
Rocket's definitely yeah, see that one.
I've seen it before.
Okay, we get it. Okay, right, I thought it was the OBS, but it's not.
We're not seriously flying into that.
You say the weather patterns of Sekhnarf 9 are tied to the temperament of this ruler.
That's not how women work.
Or weather. We're flying the wrong way.
Nah, he's not flying at all.
Guys, relax. Just one minor adjustment.
I ever mentioned how much I hate rain?
Hellbender's castle isn't even that far. That is not a castle. It is an impregnable fortress.
So how do we impregnate it?
Ask Peter!
Let's just get closer. We'll figure it out on the way.
I also love how his jacket just screams 80.
Yeah.
These merchants, we will easily gain access to Lady Hellbender.
Good. And he's got his Walkman.
We've already got a beast. Mm-hmm. All that's left is the merchant part.
Good thing I put on my official merchant costume.
There is no such thing. Right?
The fact you ain't sure don't bode so good.
Whoa! That is some really crazy lightning out there. Never seen anything like it.
Meteorological suicide is what it is.
Okay, yeah, they're really gonna give us an in-depth gameplay.
Mm-hmm.
What I always like about some of these planets is, like, there's just one color that usually just screams and just is really vibrant, so here, like, the yellow. And it really helps, because it's not just, like, a boring rock planet. Like, they're like, cool, let's just give it this color to help also make it different from the other planets. Because if anything, you can refer to it and be like, oh, yeah, the yellow planet.
It also makes sense for this kind of environment where it's all stormy and shit.
Yeah.
Because you would have a lot of, like, oh. You would have a lot of, like, moss, especially yellow moss, in, mm-hmm. like, stormy environments or, like, cooler stormy climates.
We should have gone to Maku 4. I would be wary, Rodan.
You know what? I survived freaking half.
The slime.
It's not alone. Get ready.
Gelatinous cube.
The sword kind of looked like it just clipped into her hand. Like, she didn't actually grab it.
Yeah, I think it's attached to her spine. Or, like, from her back.
Drop him, Gamora!
This won't hurt much!
Smash him up,
oh, so you can at least control them, but you play as Star-Lord.
Yeah.
Okay.
This is the local fauna! It's about to be an endangered species! Groot! Hawkeye time!
So that's a lot to manage, then.
Still looks fun.
Oh yeah, no, for sure.
I am eager to experience Lady Hellbender's legendary menagerie. Should we ask them for directions?
I'm thinking maybe they are directions.
Oh, like a signpost or something.
I'm not saying it's an arrow with the word fortress on it, but statues suggest civilization, and the only settlement I saw when we were topside
was Lady Hellbender's fortress.
Dead end. That's just great.
It's a retractable bridge. They used them at the prison I was in.
Too bad the controls are on the other side of the giant chasm.
What do you not have time to dawdle in this?
Just throw a rocket.
Hurl the creature over.
Throw
the
raccoon.
Activate the bridge.
I may activate a hole through your face. Put me down.
Now encourage him.
It'll be fine. Just curl up in a ball.
What?
Drax, throw him.
No.
Very well.
Peter.
It's okay. He'll land on his feet.
Ooh. He made it.
I guess that only applies.
Oh, there. Yeah, I like how they make note. Rocket is furious that you let him do it.
Rocket will remember this.
So I wonder how, like, the relationships between you and the other Guardians will change depending on the actions that you choose throughout the story.
Maybe.
Okay, deal.
Okay, I didn't expect that bridge to work like that.
Another choo-choo.
I got it.
Oh, that's cool. Ah, it's weird cat monsters.
These creatures are perfect predators. Stop cheering for the murder monster.
Ain't somebody having fun?
No! You are my prey.
Keep it together.
I can unfreeze him? Okay, there we go. Ooh, his ultimate.
Nice. Looks like the demo dogs.
It really does, yeah.
Uncanny. He just punches it and it dies. Is definitely in my top 10 fortresses.
Peter? Aren't you forgetting something?
Are you blue?
Oh, right. The cage.
The point of even getting the Flarkin thing was looking like we mean business.
All right, Rocket. Time to put on your monster face.
I only got one face, Quill.
Are you sure about this, Peter? Look at him. You better have one hell of a sales pitch.
Maybe Gamora's right. We should try selling Groot instead.
What? Really?
This is an affront to democracy.
I just think that we might need Rocket on the outside for this one.
I am Groot.
Yeah, we noticed. You want to make that call?
So interesting. So it's basically you can, if you replay this mission, you take the other option and you'll have
a different outcome.
Rocket style, if I got it. So very choose your own adventure style.
To guarantee your safety as a leader.
Oh, come on.
Don't look at me. I ain't pulling that thing. Remember, buddy, menacing like me, only bigger.
I am good.
Not bad.
Someone else wants to pull this thing.
I'm a dream of what I need.
We got this.
Nice. That looks very fun.
It does.
Rocky, what are you doing?
Is this just the Square Enix showcase? Is it just Guardians of the Galaxy? Because if it is, I'm going to be disappointed. But not by much.
Damn.
What the fuck?
Who's the monster now?
Let Star-Lord say fuck.
Guardians of the Galaxy. How many times do I have to kill you? The audacity. That you thought you could rob me, Dweller! Feast upon them!
Oh, damn.
The Kraken!
You got this.
Probably. All the PSs,
Xboxes, and PC.
Pre-order now. And then get the original outfits.
Why does...
Why is Rocket in a...
Also, Drax looked like Vision.
Now we're going to revisit two iconic brands that are being remastered for modern platforms. First up, relive the classic games in the Final Fantasy series.
Yep.
And then,
thanks, Matt.
One more peek at Legend of Mana ahead of its June 24th launch.
Six masterpieces.
Final Fantasy 2,
3,
4, 5, and 6. Coming soon to Steam and mobile.
Yeah, well, because it's still going to be 2D, so makes sense. Okay. So 1 through 6 are getting redone somewhat.
Episode
7 is also being remade.
7 is, yeah. And then there's this. Whatever this is. Oh, mana? I forgot they did, like, Square Enix did the mana series. Yeah!
Legend of Mana.
Yeah, because it's Legend of Mana.
It comes out, like, next week, or 2 weeks.
And then Secret of Mana is already next, Earth's remade. Mightiest heroes continue their fight to defend the world in Marvel's Avengers. Ew.
The team at Crystal Dynamics is excited to share the latest updates with you, including new mission types and a growing roster of heroes.
Spider-Man is also... They announced Spider-Man.
Yeah.
Avengers, secure that super weapon at all costs.
You seen Thor in normal clothes?
Yeah.
Keep it moving.
A cube.
Beautiful.
Oh yeah, I forgot about Hawkeye.
You're out of your depth. Yeah, Hawkeye was just recently added.
Shutting you down, Monica.
Yeah, Hawkeye, Captain Marvel. Not Captain Marvel. Yeah, Miss Marvel.
No, yeah, Miss Marvel. Miss Marvel was announced in the base game.
Okay.
AIM will save this world. I will save it.
There is no end to these clones. You don't
Scientist
understand
supreme.
What that cube is capable
save
of.
The future.
Future.
Kate Bishop too.
Mm-hmm. Now, is this going to be semi-death Hawkeye? Or is this just going to be Hawkeye?
Yeah, I don't know. War for Wakanda.
Wakanda forever? We've already seen...
I applaud your efforts to connect with your roots, but as a man who has seen 3 Black Panthers fall, I must warn you of a few things. Many eyes follow the path you are about to walk down.
They say I walk like a king, talk like a king.
You just wanted to show up.
They chasing
suit.
The
fame.
They all want the name.
But
they ain't got what's running through these veins. Make way.
It is Claw.
Man. Gollum looks weird. I don't even think he's Australian in this.
I mean, he didn't say anything, so it's hard to tell.
Yeah. Yeah, he's not Australian,
no.
Shame.
Not belong to me. It belongs to Wakanda.
Look at me now. Count me down. So give me the game. Why is he big?
That's what you gotta play to find out.
Okay. I don't think I will. Included at no additional cost. Okay. Now you have
now
my attention.
Time to give mobile players a quick look at some of the games that will be available in the coming months.
Mobile.
No, Matt, no.
Our intelligence reports a new threat to global stability. Their reach is unlike anything we have seen before.
Hitman isn't Squeenix.
Following Agent 47's disappearance.
Never mind.
You were selected because of your remarkable skills. Execution must be perfect. We will strike from the shadows, and they will never know what hit them.
Okay.
Hitman Sniper.
A sad and
oh yeah, and this is Nier Automata.
Goes throughout eternity.
Or whatever.
Yeah, I didn't know this was gonna come out mobile.
I guess it makes sense. Reincarnation.
sphere of life returns to Arda.
Final Fantasy.
War of the Visions. Was it Visions or Versions?
I think it was Visions. Which is weird, because we already had the War of the Visions in WandaVision. Oh, it's Final Fantasy Brave Exvius.
Oh, it was another thing? Okay.
Journey bestows upon those that... Okay.
More Final Fantasy!
More!
More!
But in honestly, no more. Final Fantasy Brave Exvius.
Sure.
I can't read that fast!
Because these look like more like collaborations and existing titles already.
Yeah, is this a first-person shooter? Or third-person shooter? In Final Fantasy? The First Soldier. I think his name was... Max?
Today, the team at Platinum Games is giving you an exclusive look at the epic world of Babylon's Fall, featuring fluid combat, powerful weapons, and a unique art style.
Platinum Games, what else? What else did Platinum Games do?
Bayonetta, I believe.
Okay.
And Metal Gear Rising Revengeance. But for a thousand more, so expect a lot of hack and slash potentially, and fan service.
That's what I was thinking with hack and slashing.
This is just watercolor.
That's a unique art style.
Yep, Matt didn't lie to us. Thank you, Matt, for not lying to us. Ice and the coldest of winds. Eventually, the tower became a symbol of unrelenting ambition.
That tower's name is Babylon. Babylon's Fall.
Babylon's Fall.
Does the savior of Neo Babylon stand among us? Let's find out without further ado.
Mass. Oh, even the characters are in that style. Okay. It looks like it's at a lower... It looks like it's at 480p, I'm not gonna lie. But I know that's the art style.
If I'm to die, then I'll die for hope. For what little hope there may be.
It also could just be the YouTube stream. Is that a lower quality?
Yeah, I guess.
Seen through the veil at last, have you?
You know, it's going to be a good game. There are spiders. And there's lava.
And there's lava. That's all you need for a good game is to have lava and or giant spiders.
Or some reptilian creature to fight.
Yeah.
And
you like to end up
seeing only what you believe. That's why people like Final Fantasy.
Mm-hmm.
That game's got nothing but dragons. Now, speaking of...
Two paths lie ahead. Ascend to the heaven above the tower, or fall like this one now before you.
Now begins its tale of both hope and despair.
Okay.
Okay. Developer interview.
When are you going to release it? Oh.
Platinum Games は本当にあのアクションという部分に関しては世界屈指のデベロッパーだと。
Oh, they also did Nier.
Okay.
Nier Automata でそれが証明できた。
So again, fan service. Nier Automata のアクションを and hack and slash.
このためにどうしたらいいかって選ばれたジャンルがハック&スラッシュでした。のでこのゲームのコンセプトは端的に言うと Nier Automata のアクションでハック&スラッシュ。
There are so many polygons in this in that character's ass. You could fit Skyrim in there. Why? Why do you need the entirety of Skyrim to fit into one anime ass? I ask you.
I have no idea what you are.
To be the character in Nier Automata.
Which one?
The girl?
Okay.
Apparently, she has so many polygons. Like, I have to look up how many polygons were in this. Like, when they were creating it, there were so many polygons. Like, you could fit all of Skyrim just in her ass. That's how many polygons there were. I may have that wrong. It could just be Ocarina of Time, which would make more sense.
What do you mean you can fit like Ocarina in there though?
Because there was like 10,000.
Oh, so like the amount of polygons that are in that game?
Yes.
Okay, yeah, it probably would not be Skyrim. It would probably be, yeah, be Ocarina.
But still, 10,000 polygons for an ass. Why?
Long form development interview. Now, okay, I'm glad they're like, we're not gonna make you sit through all this, so here's just a short one. Go watch the rest of it elsewhere. Life is Strange series, True Colors. The team at Deck 9 is ready to give you a deeper look at Alex Chen's psychic power of empathy. But first, here's a look at the Life is Strange remastered collection.
Feels so how do these weird to be back
all connect?
After 5 years, you're still max cost.
Do they all connect? How many of these are there?
Let's look it up.
Right, this is a collection, so it'll show it.
I think they all take place in the same town.
Okay. Jumping through Arcadia Bay. We are awesome.
What is Life is Strange about? Oh.
Come on, let's dance. I mean, it looks better, but still not the best.
Life is Strange is an episodic graphic adventure video game developed by Donut Entertainment and published by Square Enix, European subsidiary for Microsoft Windows, PlayStation 3, PlayStation 4, Xbox 360, and Xbox One.
Something happened to her. We have to find her, Max.
So it's like a mystery thriller type.
Max, what's
okay,
going
but
on
it's really just like a novel.
Essentially.
I could reverse time. What the hell is this?
But like with weird powers.
Okay.
Whatever's going on.
I think I had started watching Uber Hex and Nova play a little bit of this, the first one, and then I got bored.
I had a choice and the power to change everything.
You need to prevent the whales from being beached.
Whatever
also,
happens,
time travel, I guess, is involved.
I'll always have your back.
Interesting.
Always.
Oh yeah, because butterfly effect. That makes sense. I'm not gonna play it.
Hi, I'm Maya, also known as MXM Tune. I'm a musician and the singing voice of Alex Chen in the upcoming Life is Strange: True Colors. I hope you enjoyed that first look at official gameplay from the remastered collection. As a longtime fan, I know I did. You can see the love and care that Deck 9 have put into remastering both Life is Strange and Before the Storm. This collection features improved character animation, lip sync, and visuals, breathing new life into these two beloved games. Back in March, we
okay,
also
so it is only one. Because I always kept seeing
series
new stuff about it. That's because it probably was like, here's the next episode, here's the next episode.
Alex
and now it's
Chen
all done. So this is
the
second one.
Death. Using her
yes
psychic power of empathy to
because Before the Storm is like a prequel
of Haven Springs.
Okay.
Today we have a first look at Alex's unique power in action. Here's game director Zach Garris for more.
Alex's psychic power of empathy is integral to the story of Life is Strange: True Colors. It impacts every relationship she builds and every decision she makes.
Never thought I'd have a freaky empath friend.
For years, Alex has been unable to shut out the strong feelings of others, the fear, sadness, and anger of those around her, leading her to believe her power is a curse. In the wake of Gabe's death, Alex realizes the
was
only
that,
way
did
she
can say
find
that
the
she
truth
can feel other people's feelings, or she
power
can just sense what other people are feeling?
I
yes
can't believe this is happening.
Okay.
The auras, I believe, are her sensing, like, what they're feeling.
Okay.
So, like, red is anger, blue is sadness.
Yeah. But I wasn't sure if then she also feels that, too.
She does, yes.
Okay. ...into people's emotions.
These valuable insights deepen Alex's relationships with the folk of Haven Springs, as well as sparking new dialogue options and events, as here, from a scene very early on in the game.
You're gonna lose her. You're gonna lose her, and it's all your fault.
Alex has uncovered a secret that Mac wants to keep hidden from his long-term girlfriend, and now he is terrified that Alex will reveal it before he can talk to Riley.
She is the best thing that's ever happened to me. So please, help me out.
Mac's telling you a whole lot of bullshit.
Listen.
Thanks for telling me the truth, Alex.
But are we still together?
Are you serious? I need to get back to work.
Sure, Alex, we'll get out of your way.
When Alex encounters a particularly strong aura, she can reach out to actively connect.
Again, kind of like the Guardians emotions. Here. You can go
this generates
multiple nova, pathways, build,
supernatural flare that transforms
adventure,
the world around Alex into a reflection of that person's
what
psyche.
Is it called?
In this altered,
choose your own adventure.
Charged state, Alex can experience fragments of thoughts and memories to get to the root of their issue. But not every emotional crisis can be easily dealt with. Some carry a dangerous, even life-threatening, amount of power.
He's dead! I wish I were too.
No decision is easy, and the consequences will be felt across the game.
This anger could kill her. What if I could just take it away?
What if I killed her?
Using Alex's powers, the only way you can uncover the truth behind her
it's
brother's
like
death.
What would that do to her?
That would kill her.
What would it do to me? And even if I can, should I?
How far will you go in pursuit of that truth? The choice is yours.
Alex's powers look so awesome. I have no idea how I'll make some of these choices, but I can't wait to play it with you all when it comes out on September 10th. Don't forget, you can pre-order Life is Strange True Colors now. And if you choose the Ultimate Edition, you'll also receive the Life is Strange Remastered Collection. And that's it for today. Make sure to follow the Life is Strange social channels for more.
Okay. I'm probably not going to do that. With the power of rainbows, I can feel everything. Okay, so that's coming out
and
soon.
And now, we are excited to unveil a brand new title from Square Enix Japan.
Is that how you're meant to pronounce it?
Square Enix?
I'm not going to do that, Matt Mercer. I'm going to call it Squeenix.
Square Enix is all just about, like, these high fantasy
that's my mission.
Games.
Yeah, well, especially Square Enix Japan.
He did ya!
They don't seem like ninjas.
Looks like chaos has been
I've seen
for
Team
us.
Ninja before. I'm trying to think of what else.
Boitecmo.
They're the guys who did the original Hyrule Warriors.
Yeah, that's what I thought.
I
so
only know
another hack and slash mob rush.
Need to.
And it doesn't seem very mob rush.
It's not a hope or a dream. It's like a hunger.
But it'll be a hack and slash.
Actually, it looks kind of cool.
You sure chaos is here?
Turning everything into crystals and blowing it up.
Yeah. Also, this guy doesn't look like the main guy. Doesn't look like he belongs in a high fantasy world like everyone else.
No.
It looks like he was dragged into this world. He's like, look, man, I have a 9-to-5. I gotta get back to the coffee shop. I don't have time for this shit.
This is it, no doubt.
Oh.
There was a knight who left on the same journey as you.
But young Trevor, you are the chosen one. It's like, I don't care.
I don't have time for this.
Unless you're gonna pay my rent, I'm not doing this shit. We will give...
Yeah, because he's just dressed like in normal clothes.
Yeah. We will give you... $500 if you go on this adventure. All right, I'm in.
And who are you?
We're here to kill Chaos, the Prophecy's very own Warriors of Light.
See, because he's got different colored hair, though, he definitely looks like he should be here.
Yes. Wore such splendid armor. He's like, I don't care about this cosplay bullshit. I gotta get back to work.
No. I become Chaos.
Chaos Control.
Stranger of Paradise.
Final Fantasy Origin.
Of course it's a Final Fantasy.
Huh. A bold new version of Final Fantasy coming next year. Soon. If it just said soon there, like no context, just
I'll leave you with a look at some of the amazing Square Enix titles you can play now, as well as those to come.
Okay.
Yep. Final Fantasy 7, Chapter 2.
And it's Yuffie.
I'm gonna drop plate number 7.
They're gonna do what?
Well done with you, Neo.
Life is strange, true colors.
We've already seen these.
Mm-hmm. And more to come.
Forspoken.
Yes, that's the... I don't know what that one was.
It looked cool.
It did. That one was literally just a girl gets transported to another world and is just like, what the fuck is happening?
Thank you for joining us today.
That was it?
Out for news about our next Square Enix Presents.
Oh, never mind.
Okay. Matt Mercer, see you next time.
Okay, bye, Matt.
Thanks, Matt Mercer.
You didn't really do much, but okay. I guess that was it.
Is it really it?
That feels like it was it.
It was only 45 minutes.
Well, I mean, it is just one company instead of like...
That's true. Yeah, that's what I was wondering. Like, how long could this be? Like, how much do they have?
That apparently, it's not that they had a lot, but they had a lot to show.
Yeah. Whether it was new or already announced.
Mm-hmm.
And, I mean, the Guardians, when they showed a very in-depth video for, and for some of the other ones too, Final Fantasy and the True Colors. Well, so that was that.
Yeah.
Not too much, but I wasn't expecting... Also that much for Square Enix either.
But it still got me hyped for, like, some of the games.
Yeah, the Guardians of the Galaxy one I'm really interested in.
Mm-hmm.
I'd still like to play the Avengers one as well. And a lot of... There's just a lot of high fantasy.
It is a lot of high fantasy, which is right up my alley.
Yeah.
I'm very curious about that Final Fantasy Origins
mm-hmm.
game that they showed, because it doesn't feel like Final Fantasy.
Yeah.
It just feels like fantasy.
Yes.
And a guy trying to get to his 9-to-5.
Yeah. Those character designs and costuming was really interesting, but it'll be interesting to see where it goes, especially because it's a new way to play Final Fantasy. Or, like, it doesn't look like it's your... Well, I guess a lot of... They're getting away from the turn-based.
Yes.
But it's still different.
We still haven't seen, like, a release date or any actual gameplay, like a UI HUD. From the Final Fantasy 16 that they announced way back last E3 and barely talked about it this E3.
Yeah, probably because they're probably trying to do so much with it, so they're like, okay, we gotta wait. And then if they're still doing 7 too,
yeah,
it just makes it a lot. There's just a lot to do.
Yeah.
Well, let us know in the comments what you're excited for,
and maybe if you want us to play any of these games when they come out.
Yeah, we're always looking for more games to play, and we want to play what you guys want to see.
Yes.
So make sure to like, comment, subscribe, hit the notification bell, follow all of our social medias.
Subscrizzle, buy our merch.
Support the Patreon.
Yeah.
Yeah.
All that jazz.
And thank you guys again for watching. We'll catch you next time.
Bye-bye.